All right, 5 minutes after 9 o'clock, Dr. Michael Lange is in the studio. If you have a question about your eyes, your eye health, your eyeglasses, your contacts, there's no question too big or too small for Dr. Lange. He handles them all. I've even asked him how to clean my glasses. How small do you get? But you can't get any smaller than that. Also, nutritional health. Dr. Lange is here to answer your questions about your vitamins, et cetera. And good morning, doctor.
Good morning. Great to be here, guys.
That was a kind of a sloppy intro, wasn't it? It wasn't as nice and smooth as it normally is. But anyway, I'm trying to do three things at once. You're looking good on the TV. You got the light shining on you.
Wow, what a studio we got here.
I know.
I had makeup and wardrobe, everything right beforehand. But, you know, getting here an hour early is a little ridiculous these days.
That's cool. That's cool. Yeah,
that's
Joe,
right.
Joe, Dr. Lange has a good idea. Makeup and wardrobe out there. somebody came in this morning, and I hope he doesn't mind me sharing this, but he has a friend he believes is going blind. I said, take her to see Dr. Lange. Because what you've told us is that it's either macular degeneration, which you can stop in its tracks, maybe not reverse. Am I right? Did I tell him the right thing?
Well, absolutely. With macular degeneration, depending on the type, okay, we can actually slow it down dramatically. Sometimes we can even reverse it.
Reverse it?
Reverse it. That's okay. Absolutely correct. Remember, macular degeneration is the leading cause of vision impairment in this country over the age of 55. I didn't say blindness. I said vision impairment. There's a big difference between vision impairment and blindness. When you're blind, that's like your eyes are closed. You can't see anything. That's
right.
Blind.
Right.
Okay?
Right.
You can go totally blind from glaucoma. You can go totally blind from diabetes. Macular degeneration, usually you do not go totally blind. Worst case scenario, you lose your central vision. So when I'm looking at you, I may not see your facial characteristics, but I'll see your body. A lot of the elderly people look out the sides of their vision like this. That's called eccentric viewing, so they can see facial characteristics and things of this nature. So macular degeneration is bad, but we have a lot of treatments these days that are amazing compared to what we had a few years ago. And we're in the process of building the most advanced retina center in probably in Florida in our Lange Eye Care Ocala location, and we're actually going to be open April 18th, 19th, and 20th to start seeing patients there of this year. We've hired a world-renowned medical doctor, PhD also in biochemistry, that's been on my advisory board for the vitamin company as well. So he's in tune with nutrition as well as the latest in surgical intervention. He also is one of the leading authorities in the country on genetic and stem cell research.
Oh, wow.
For macular degeneration, retinitis pigmentosa, and diabetic retinopathy. Some exciting things coming down the pike at Lange Eye Care.
Now, we have a phone call, but real quickly, the other scary words, glaucoma and diabetic blindness.
Right, diabetic retinopathy and glaucoma. And what the key with all of this is early detection.
Early.
And that's, I think, what sets us apart at Lange Eye Care and Associates. You know, all of the doctors are in tune with nutrition. They either have degrees in nutrition or they're certified nutritional specialists. And so we try to use nutrition to help the body fight against these visually debilitating diseases. God made a pretty good body. If we give the fuel necessary, that body is going to work and help to fight against diseases in the eye.
And we do have that phone call waiting patiently. Good morning. Thank you for waiting patiently. You're on the air.
This is no name.
This is no name.
I need a phone number. Dr. Lange.
Okay. Let me give you our main office in Ocala, and that is 237-3768. 237-3768.
Got it. 237-3768.
Right. And if a patient specifically wants to see me, just make sure you say that, you know, I want to see Dr. Lange only. Otherwise, you know, I've got a lot of great doctors on staff, but a lot of people that hear me on the radio, you know, want to see me, and then they're surprised when they come in and they don't see me. So
no,
just say specifically Dr. Lange.
Just need some expert help. Thank you.
All right.
All right. Yeah. And good morning. You're on the air with Dr. Lange.
Yes, good morning, Dr. Lange.
Good morning.
I've been reading material here recently on a fish oil replacement called krill, K-R-I-L-L. It's
right.
Kind of a shrimp situation there, a derogatory from shrimp,
right.
Crustacean. Can you give me some ideas on your thinking on that subject?
Absolutely. I'm an expert in this field. As a matter of fact, 2 years ago, I actually went to Norway, to Oslo, Norway,
yeah,
which is the home of omega-3, to try to actually probably bring back either krill oil or squid oil. But after doing research for almost a month there, I did not come back with either. I came back with something called Fortify Super Omega, made from species of cold water fish. And the reason for this is, you know, krill is based on some legitimate science, okay? But the krill manufacturers are hyping it out of the universe. And the reason for this is they're making the almighty buck, all right? If you look at krill, remember, omega-3 is omega-3. No matter if it comes from krill, squid, green mussel, fish, whatever it comes from, omega-3 is omega-3. So if you get 100 milligrams of EPA and 100 milligrams of DHA, doesn't matter the source, okay? Right. Now what happens is krill, milligram for milligram, I'll admit it, due to the phospholipids that are in it, it is a little bit more bioavailable than, say, fish oil, milligram for milligram. But krill is not putting hardly any efficacy, any therapeutic dosage in their little tiny red pills, okay, these omega krills. If you look and see how much EPA and DHA is in it, it's absolutely a joke. Most omega-3 experts are tending to agree with this and almost want to say it's almost a scam, to be honest with you.
Oh, boy.
Now, there are some very select krill manufacturers that are starting to put some very high dosages, but it's super expensive, over $100 a bottle, and you can't find it on the store shelf. The ones you buy on the store shelf, if you look at the EPA and the DHA, the EPA is about 40 and the DHA is about 20. Some of them are a little bit higher. The highest I have ever found is a combination of EPA and DHA of 500. That's the highest I've ever found. Now, we've done testing, and we have found that the EPA should be around 900 and the DHA should be around 600, give or take a little bit. So 900 and 600 to actually move your omega index over 9%.
Yeah.
And that's a therapeutic level. So if you're taking krill, it's based on hype, you're probably wasting your money.
All right.
So stay away from it.
Okay, so you're saying, yeah, stay away from it. Just for,
right.
Keep with the fish oil as is, omega-3, and you'll be fine, huh?
Absolutely. And those levels, EPA of close to 900, close to 600, and make sure it's triglyceride form, not the ethyl ester form, because triglyceride form is about three times more bioavailable than the ethyl ester form. The ethyl ester form causes gastric irritation, causes you to burp up a nasty fish taste, and this is why they're enteric coating them now. If you see something that's enteric coated, that means it probably is causing gastric distress, so they don't want it to dissolve until it gets into your small intestine.
Yeah.
Be careful.
Okay, thanks for your information very much. Thank you.
All right, take care.
When people are diagnosed with cataracts, can macular degeneration be forming the same time as the cataracts are?
Absolutely. These are age-related processes. You know, we get certain things in life if we live long enough. No matter who you are, if you live long enough, you're going to get wrinkles, you're going to get gray hair. If you work, you're going to have taxes, and you're going to get cataracts, okay? I have never looked in a 75-year-old eye and not seen a cataract ever. Now, to what extent is a different story. If that cataract starts to impair your vision and starts to impair your quality of vision and thus your quality of life, that cataract needs to come out. But let's say you have a grade 2, 2.5 cataract. We grade them on a scale 1 to 4, and you don't have any symptoms. You still have legal driving vision. You got 20/40 vision, and you don't think you need 20/20 vision. You have absolutely no symptoms and you're happy. There's no reason for that cataract to come out. So you got to beware of the surgeon that says that cataract needs to come out and you have no symptoms, all right? Remember, surgery is not without potential complications. Even in the hands of the most competent surgeon, there are potential risks. So there's an old saying, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. And I think that's one reason we've been so successful at Lange Eye Care. I mean, we are honest with our patients. I have patients that have come in for 10 years and their prescription, their glasses hasn't changed. And I tell them, you know, Ms. Smith, Mr. Jones, you know, there's no reason to change your glasses unless you just want a new frame because your prescription hasn't changed. Some of these patients come in, they kind of feel sorry for me. They say, you know, Dr. Lange, you've been so honest with me over the last 5, 6, 10 years. I just want to buy a pair of glasses. I want to support you. And they go out and buy a pair of glasses. Yeah. Same thing with cataracts. You know, I've been seeing patients for 20 years, and some of my patients 20 years ago had cataracts, and they came in for a second opinion saying, you know, my doctor said I had to have cataract surgery. I've seen them for 20 years. We still haven't had to take their cataracts out. So you know when that cataract needs to come out. You have lots of glare. You have blurred vision. You can't see the things you want. Then it needs to come out. So we've got great cataract surgeons on our staff at Lange Eye Care. And like I said, we have great retinal surgeons now as well. So we cover the full gamut from pediatric to geriatric, from major surgery just to medical treatment and nutritional intervention, which is actually very huge now. I am an advisory board member for the Ocular Nutrition Society, which is the largest ocular nutrition society in the world. And, you know, our mission is to teach doctors optometrists, optometric physicians, ophthalmologists, primary care physicians, whoever it may be, to teach them about nutrition so they can utilize that with their patients to slow down the aging process in the eye and in the body. Remember, I always say if it's eye healthy, it's heart healthy. And so getting back to talking about macular degeneration, you know, the key first is to diagnose the problem and diagnose it correctly. So you got to go to a center that has state-of-the-art equipment, digital retinal photography, something called OCT technology, which is cross-sectional imaging of the retina, fluorescein angiography, and then a functional test to actually see how the retina is functioning, something called PHP or visual field testing, so you can actually monitor these patients for progression. Then you have to diagnose that patient with either dry or wet macular degeneration. Then you have to formulate a game plan. And I think that's what sets us apart and makes us very unique. We use genetic testing combined with intracellular blood analysis to look at modifiable risk factors in the blood, believe it or not, to look for nutritional deficiencies and to look for things like elevated homocysteine, C-reactive protein, triglycerides, cholesterol, LP little A. I mean, these are lipoproteins that are modifiable risk factors for macular degeneration. Then we look at all that. We look at your genetic test and see how predisposed you are from 1 to 5 to going blind before you die. We look at the nutritional deficiencies. We look at your blood chemistry. And then, like I said, we develop a plan of attack, a nutritional lifestyle dietary change modification plan of attack first, if you have the dry form. So we write out a diet for patients. We tell them the exercises to do, what color sunglasses to wear, things like this that indeed work. I have patients that we have a reversed dry macular degeneration. We have the proof. We can show you the reversal, that improvement. Now, if you have wet macular degeneration, this is the more visually devastating. This is the type that causes fluid and blood to go under the retina, causes massive vision loss very quickly. We still use the same treatment modalities for dry, the dietary adjustments, lifestyle adjustments, things of this nature, blocking the harmful blue light and UV light via the right filters, via sunglasses. But then we have to determine what type of injection to do if indeed injection is going to work. Macugen, Avastin, Lucentis, a new one called Eylea, whether an anti-VEGF or a VEG-trap medication is going to work. Whether or not some of this new research that we're getting involved in with stem cell and genetic research will actually help the retina. And whether or not a combination therapies of injections, cold laser treatment, and nutritional therapy will work. So we've come a long way. Just about, what, 6-7 years ago, if you had wet macular degeneration, you'd go to your retina specialist and they'd hit you with a laser. They would try to stop the fluid and swelling and leakage and blood with a laser, and that laser would destroy that part of the retina. So you'd go in not seeing too good, they'd laser your eye, and you'd leave seeing a lot worse. I mean, I felt for these retina specialists, and then the patient, it was hard to explain, well, we saved your vision, but we destroyed a lot of your vision to save some vision.
Oh,
we
no.
don't do that anymore. Yeah, now, yeah, with the advent of these anti-VEGF medications anti-VEG trap and things like this, we've come a long way in the treatment. Now we can slow down even the wet form of macular degeneration, but the key is to find a competent optometrist, optometric physician, or ophthalmologist that can diagnose it and then follow it appropriately, and then, you know, a great fellowship-trained retinal specialist that's in tune with proper nutrition as well as medical and surgical treatment. Here's where we have a big problem right now, a big disconnect in this country with retina specialists, in my opinion, is they're in tune with doing the injections and surgery, medical treatments, but they're not in tune with nutrition. They're still recommending some of these archaic vitamin formulas, like the ARADS 1 formula. This was a combination of 25,000 milligrams of beta-carotene, 400 units of synthetic vitamin E, 80 milligrams of zinc, 2 milligrams of copper, and 500 milligrams of vitamin C. This was developed almost 15 years ago, and it's archaic. Beta-carotene blocks the absorption of lutein. In my opinion, those formulas do more harm than good. So we've developed newer formulas now, but many of these doctors, optometrists, and ophthalmologists aren't in tune with the nutritional aspects, so they're still recommending some of these older products that, in my opinion, are doing more harm than good. And just to promote one of my products, Fortify Complete Macular Defense is based on 8 years of studies. We've redeveloped this formula now 8 times in the last 6 years. It's being prescribed by doctors all over the world now, And it's actually helping. It's helping the general health, and it's helping ocular health. Fortify Complete Macular Defense. Learn more about it at our website at fortify.com. That's F-O-R-T-I-F-E-Y-E. Call Arlene at Fortify Vitamins if you don't have an internet, and ask her to send you a new article I wrote on nutritional intervention, lifestyle modification, supplementation for macular degeneration. I just published it, about 3 weeks ago, and it's free. We'll send it out to you in some samples and a lot of information on nutrition. Call Arlene at 866-503-9746. One more time, write this number down, 866-503-9746. That goes straight to Fortify. And like I said, there's something that I put a lot of passion in is proper nutrition. If you're not going to take the Fortify, then look at the nutritional profile, try to put something together similar to it, and go looking at the health food store and start doing it.
Yeah, it would cost you a lot more, I would think.
It would be a lot more.
Just going back to what you said earlier about some of the people who had the treatment that actually did them more harm than good, but stopped it from progressing, the macular degeneration. Do you foresee, and this is, I guess, a future question, but do you foresee that the stem cell research that is being done might actually help those people who lost their sight in those procedures?
It's a very good possibility, because stem cells, in theory, help to grow back new tissue. And if we can grow new retinal tissue in areas that have been destroyed, that could be amazing. You know, we're working on microchip implants right now. There's a lot of research where they're taking people that are blind and returning their vision with microchip implants, something similar to a bionic eye. They're actually taking people that don't even have eyes and using a micro camera mounted to a pair of spectacles and giving them some semblance of vision.
You know,
so where we're going to be a few years from now is going to be pretty amazing.
And that's
not so hard to believe. My mom right now is rehabilitating in an assisted living facility. There's a man there with a hearing aid, but he has no hearing at all. The hearing aid is attached to his head, right behind his ear. Mm-hmm. So he's really hearing with his brain and the device.
So he has one of those new cochlear implants, I think.
It's for his ear, though.
Right.
Is that the same?
It might be one of those new implants.
Yeah, so he has no hearing at all, but he can hear. Isn't that amazing?
I
guess Rush Limbaugh has the same thing, it sounds like. All right, let's go to the phone. Good morning. You're on the air with Dr. Lange.
Good morning, Dr. Lange.
Good morning.
We're going to be buying a part of our body in a few years with the stem cells, whatever is going on. However, what I wanted to ask, why you, you don't have a meeting about nutrition in Ocala? Everything is in the Fort Myers, whatever. Clear water.
Yeah, I just did a big meeting in Crystal River with a big group talking about macular degeneration and nutrition. I did one not too long ago in the Villages. I do some in Clearwater. I haven't done one in Ocala in many years. I used to do some up over at Top of the World. I haven't done that lately. It's just, you know, there just isn't enough time in the day to do everything. I know I go to a lot of conferences. I lecture a lot. So I'm out and about in different states and different countries now. But you can always come in and see me in the office. You can always call me. I'm always available on the phone, on the internet, and certainly tuning into the radio shows. You know, I'm on Wednesdays. I'm on Thursday afternoons. Saturday mornings.
I listen to you all the time. I wanted to ask, where do you find the right olive oil? Because I understand that the olive oil is mixed now with all kinds of stuff.
Well, you know, I'm not as big an advocate of olive oil as I used to be, okay? Olive oil is a good source of omega-9, something called oleic acid. But you know what I like better now, and you've probably heard me talking about it, is coconut oil, okay? Because coconut oil is a medium-chain triglyceride. It's very high in a compound called lauric acid, and it truly has some anti-aging properties. One of the problems with olive oil, when you heat it up, it actually turns into a carcinogen.
Well, I don't use it. I use it just like that. I never use the olive oil.
Well, on olive oil, you need to get organic, extra virgin olive oil. And then I think you're relatively safe. You got to stay away from canola oil because it's all genetically modified. You got to stay away from corn oil as well.
Yeah.
But my main cooking oil now is coconut oil.
Is that very high in calories?
It's high in saturated fat, that's true, but it's a good saturated fat, all right? We used to think it was a bad saturated fat, but all saturated fats aren't created equal. It will not make you gain weight, believe it or not. Due to the way it's set up, the nutritional component, it actually helps you lose weight, just the opposite. So the calorie content is nothing to worry about in coconut oil. Now remember, everything in moderation. And I recommend 2 teaspoons a day to just about everybody over 40, and then cooking with it. You will not have to worry about the calorie content.
But a few years ago, they were on television always, you be careful with coconut oil, it clogs your arteries and this and this and that.
Yep, but we live and learn, don't we? What we used to say, you know, we used to say, stay out of the sun, don't eat red meat, don't eat eggs. We're putting that all back in the diet. We used to think coconut oil was terrible. We used to think it was kind of like a trans fat, but it is not. You got to stay away from trans fats, obviously. Coconut oil is something very good. There's a website you can go to called coconutketones.com. And it explains it really well. But, yeah, trust me, you can eat coconut oil, and it will help prevent different types of neurodegenerative disorders. It helps to prevent viral, fungal, and bacterial infections. It's great for the skin. You can use it as a lotion. It's great for a hair conditioner.
Oh, yeah, I have coconut oil all the time. But I use it for all kinds of stuff.
The coconut oil, make sure it has no trans fats. It's not been, destroyed. Make sure it's... Once again, the same thing, virgin organic coconut oil. The one I like the best is called Nativia. Yeah.
That's
an
Hebrew name.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, thank you so much.
All right, you take care.
Thank you.
Is macular degeneration in the genes, can it be hereditary?
Absolutely. And we're one of the select group of doctors in Florida now, which we're doing genetic testing, and it's not a blood test. It's simply a swab on the inside of the cheek. We do it at the Lange Institute in the Villages, and we do it at a main Ocala office. It just takes a minute to do, and it takes about 3 weeks to get the results. And basically, it has a results 1 to 5. 5 is an extreme. 5 means you've got 90% chance you're going to go blind from, or vision become vision impaired from wet macular degeneration before you die. So if you have a 5, you know you have to be super proactive in what you're doing. You really got to take to heart what I'm saying, all right? If you have a 1, if you got a 1, you got a little bit of breathing room, okay? So this genetic test is very important because it really impresses upon the patient how important it is to adjust their lifestyle, their diet, their supplements, and they really start to listen. An example is about a year ago I did a genetic test on a patient, and he's been a patient of mine for 20 years, and overweight, smoking, and never would change his diet or change his lifestyle. No matter what I said, no matter what his primary care physician said, he had a 4 on that genetic risk factor, which correlated with probably about a 70% chance he was going to go blind from macular degeneration or become vision impaired. Now in a year, he's lost about 100 pounds, stopped smoking, and totally adjusted his lifestyle. The threat of going blind was much more impressed upon him than the threat of having a heart attack.
Yeah.
And so it's a good test. The genetic test is a good test. But I only recommend doctors doing the genetic test if they're going to be having a proactive solution to change that patient's life. If you just do the test and say, oh, you got a 4 or 5, then you're going to scare the tar out of the patient, and you shouldn't have done it, all right? But if you're going to help that patient become proactive in their overall health and in their retinal future health, by adjusting their diet, getting more sleep, losing the weight, drinking the right fluids, taking the right vitamins, something like Fortify Complete Macular Defense, then I think these doctors should be doing this genetic test. But I don't recommend doctors doing the genetic test unless they're in tune with nutrition and in tune with natural ways of helping the patient.
The phone number here right now, if you want to take advantage of the last few seconds, my goodness, we're very close to the bottom, 622-9622. Maybe better suggestion is to call Dr. Lang at his office, since we are so close to the bottom. And what is your number again, doctor?
237-3768. That's main office in Ocala, 237-3768. Remember, our new generation retina center opens April 18th, 19th, and 20th. You can start calling and setting up appointments to see our new retina doctor. But he's been in the business for 20 years.
Where is that going to be, the location?
Right in Ocala at our main office.
Oh, okay.
We're starting out downstairs, and then we'll be moving upstairs, building a beautiful facility for him.
Nice.
Well, good to see you again. And for those who missed it, just got the tail end of it, we are putting this up as a podcast and as a video podcast as well. So we'll be doing both before the afternoon is over, I hope. Dr. Lang, thank you for all you do for all of us.
Thanks for having me.
We'll take a little break and be right back.
Ocala's information station, 1370 W.